South Korea. Because of my English, you may have some difficulty in understanding my English. Please understand. Anyway, I made this presentation with TAP, GTAP and Beamer. So I run Skin. So this is PDF, not Keynote. So this presentation is design is based on the tema Ballroom in Keynote. So someone's it looks like Keynote, but it's not Keynote. I borrowed the back background image I borrowed. And today I'll give a talk about my toy DYAS. And I give you a very interesting story. Once upon a time in the tag world, there were two file formats. One was called DIY, and the other was called PDF. In appearance, PDF looks beautiful. Yeah, but DIY was not. How about their ages? Who is younger? PDF is born at 1993, so 16 years old. But PDF, 1979, so 30 years old.
Younger than I.
Who's younger?
However, people cannot judge by appearances. So. I'd like to the inside. So inside, DIY is simple, very simple. But PDF is complex, as much as
almost all women are.
So the first topic is why I stick to DIY. So the image of Beauty and Beast tells everything. The real beauty of DIY is simplicity. I think this simplicity is the real beauty. So DIY format has in DIY format. Neither font nor graphics is embedded. So the size is very small because there is nothing in some sense. And the data is included in DIY format is just the font name, scaled size, and characters and their positions, just position on page. That's enough. That's data. And the structure is also simple because it was consists of the angle, font definitions, and post angle, and several pages. So DIY is easy to handle, very easy to handle. But in these days, people want more and more features, like various fonts, open types, and many things, and colors, and color scheme is very complex too. Graphics and even interactive features too, and multimedia. So complexity comes always after beauty. Then is DIY obsolete? Then, or is it a waste to throw away?
I think it's too good for storing or keeping in your garage or warehouse. In Chinese proverb, there is famous one, chicken's lips. Do you know?
what it means?
No.
It is like a chicken's lips is I do not want to give chicken's lips to others, but if I want to eat, it's not good. Yeah. This situation, Chinese people says, is chicken's lips. Then, so I want to find device new logo in the tag world, in the current tag world. So I thought, what it was, what is the new logo? So the because it is very simple, the structure is simple, it can be transformed to any format easily. So I want to make this format as an intermediate format, intermediate, not a final product, intermediate format. I review DeFi file structures faster. At first, FreeAmber has this kind of data, ID. So Donald Knuth's DeFi format, not fuck, F-U-C-H?
David Fuchs.
Fuchs. His DeFi format has ID 2, and P-TECH has extended ID 3, and G-TECH XDeFi has ID 5. So 2, 3, and 5 is assigned, and numerate and denominate was defined right there. It's a kind of default value in these days. And magnification is default value is 1,000, as you know. And comment is here, just simple. And post-amber is FreeAmber plus the maximum vertical plus depth size and maximum horizontal size and maximum stack size and total pages. That's it. And font in font definitions, font name, design size, scaled size, checksum was written like this one. For example, CMR 10, add design size 10 point and scaled size 12 point. But in these days, design size was not used anymore, and checksum was not used anymore. So just two, font name and scaled size. And pages. For pages, we use many DeFi comments. Up to now, 254 DeFi comments were assigned. At first, for fonts, font definition comments, here, 1, 2, 3, 4. It's simple, because font DEF1 requires 1 byte as an argument. 2 requires 2 bytes as an argument. Just enough, this one. And font selection has many comments. This one is, he assigned from 0 to 63. So 64 font numbers were assigned. It means without argument, the number was assigned. And if the number were, or if DeFi contains more than 64, then they use it. 1, 2, 3, 4, right there. And type setting part is character type setting for character type setting. Because in this time, they use ASCII code. They require just this 128 characters. And another 4 characters, Z1, Z2, Z3, 4, and 1, 2, 3, 4. The difference between set and put is set is after type setting characters and move, and put does not move. The difference is just this one. And also there is a box comment, means set rule and put rule. It gives just the width and height black box. It's enough. It's all of type setting comments in DeFi format. And moving, horizontal moving for right 1, 2, 3, 4. And two registers, W and X. It's a kind of register. And for vertical, down 1, 2, 3, 4, and two registers, Y and G.
Simple.
And other DeFi commands, special commands, XXX. Well, I don't know why they choose XXX, but it's convention, XXX. Stack commands push and pop, and file positions commands like this. This one is 249 comments were assigned at first the original D5 format. And extensions, PTAG means Japanese PTAG. Japanese PTAG uses 255 for direction, vertical direction. And JTAG uses 1, 2, 3, 4. So what is the number that is not assigned just one? What is? 250.
Just one is remaining.
So why I stick to D-Y?
I gave three talks.
Just this is third time, but 2003 in Hawaii, I gave a talk introducing D-Y PDFMX, my original project. And 2004, as I know, Professor Okumura made a video conference about the CJK language with Omega. And 2005, I gave a talk about the practical use of special commands in D5 PDFMX. All these talks are related to D5 format. So here is three posters. So I gave this one my talk at the 2003. The page was not. So what is D5 PDFMX? D5 PDFMX is a D5 drive program, D5 web utility from generating PDF from D5. You know, D5 PDFM is well known, and it was made by Wicks, but he does not develop this program anymore. So we tried to make this extensions. The history is wrong in some sense. We started 2001 because the first Hirata started D5 PDFM JPM. It means to support PTAG. He tried this one, and I tried Korean TAG. I started D5 PDFM Core. So we combined or joined. 2002, we made D5 PDFM CJK, and then the name was changed to D5 PDFM X. So D5 PDFM X is, I think, more than 80, or around 80% of code is related to font handling. Because we are, as I know, the first program handling CJK, fonts in some sense, 16-bit fonts directly in PDF. Usually, you may think PDF Tech 2, but PDF Tech does not like this one. PDF Tech controls 16-bit fonts dividing into 8 bits, and then they use right hand 8-bit control.
The only, not the only,
and also Apple's PDF engine, rendering engine, they have this kind of features too.
Anyway,
so this was the last page of my 2003 talk. So that future. it was 2003. Font mapping files comparable to those of devices. It was done. Because so, now D5 PDFMX and PDF Tech have the same font mapping files, so we do not need to generate both independently. So another goal was catch up with PDF Tech. I want to make D5 PDFMX having as many features as PDF Tech. And also, this one is also, and TTAG and FTTAG was. And SourceForge net is not important in some sense. So my interest was cell font scheme in both PDF Tech and DYPS is, no one developed DYPS, so. But PDF Tech, after that, he gave this cell font scheme. He supported this one in PDF term. We can use it. You do not know what there is. And shared key font architecture, this is important one. But it's very difficult in some sense, very complex one. So it's not, I think, LuaTeX, how about LuaTeX?
LuaTeX solves it.
Shared key font architecture is somewhat a little different. I think XPDF can do that, I think.
LuaTeX does it. It's the only way to include any font with more than 256 characters in PDF anyway.
Oh, it's different. The structure is quite different. CID, because CID key
so
font...
So does ZTEX. So does ZTEX.
Yeah, ZTEX is... ZTEX is very related to this program.
Oh, okay.
So no problem.
The Taco implemented the same thing.
Anyway.
Some possible printers class, anyway.
I think I thought PSCID font and DBPSR, we ignore this PDF Omega, and I wanted to have Omega 3. I think this one is now LuaTeX. Completely LuaTeX.
Omega 3 is very much faster.
It was 2003. And 2005, I gave a talk about the device specials. Device special is a very simple one. It is the only way of tag to communicate with the DVI utilities. This is just the only one-way connection from tag to utility, not utility to tag. There is no way. But PDF tag or GTAG can do that. But this kind of DVI drivers cannot do that. This is the weakest point in some sense. So if you know DVI is an abbreviation of device independent format, but if you use specials, it became DVD. Nothing DVI. Device dependent it became. So there are many specials, but these specials are dependent on their own DVI drivers. So I tried to make many examples, and many users wants for me to check their examples right then. Yes. So every time I need to learn tag to generate what I wanted, some special or some specific DVI comments or special comments, I always terrible. So I really wanted to have DVI editing tool. So I tried. We know DVI type because it is very old, 1982. And DVI type, the goal of DVI type is validating DVI files. So DVI file is okay or not. They check. And Knus says that it is a kind of an example of developers of DVI utility. So I think every DVI utilities are based on this program. But it is one-way program from DVI to text, not the opposite direction was not supported. So I tried to find another program. There was device independent text language, DTL. It was the last version was released 1995, COVID file. So it gives the DVI to DT and DT to DVI. It gives a one-to-one correspondence between DVI and DTL, and it's two-way. But there is a big weak point. It means it is not flexible. It means not human-friendly. So. This is DVI type output. It's not easy to understand in some sense. DTL is somewhat better, but we give all information, and also every numbers are represented in the unit ASCII scaled point. So we cannot use point or inch or inch. Centimeter like that. It was at first the weakest point of
this problem was bad one. So I want to make my own DVI editing tool. So I give some examples show time. It's very simple in some sense. We have like this kind. You may see content. Hello.tag. If I run this one tag hello, we get DVI hello.dvi and DVI ASM. Hello.dvi. Then we get this kind of things. It is a preamble, postamble, font definition, and page information. What it gives, it is easy. Push down minus like this, and set hello like this. And also, we make this one to back to DVI file, this one, DVI ASM, hello.dump.dvi, like this one. Oh. We can generate DVI. We can check this one, DVI PDFMX, hello.dump. And open
like this.
This was not generated by tab, generated by DVIS ASM. Like this one. We can give many examples. How many times do I have?
About 15.
Okay. Another example is this is simple example. Another example is PTAG. This is PTAG, Japanese PTAG. So Nihongo or Japanese character are here. So we can try this one. And here is PTAG minus sample.dvi. This one is because I should run this one with PTAG like this one. Use local PTAG. Then I get this one. Because there is no PTAG in tag line, I should have this one. And DVI ASM. PTAG minus sample DVI. Then we get this one. But Japanese characters were broken because there is encoding problem. Encoding. So we give encoding information here, like PTAG. Because PTAG uses default SAIS encoding, we use this kind of encoding. The broken characters were encoded in Unicode. So I use UTF-8 as a default encoding. So it is, it supports Omega and PTAG and JTAG and RuaTAG too. But for JTAG and RuaTAG, only one way connection, one way.
Not two way. There, I will explain why. Anyway,
so the structure of DVI ASM is simple. This one. We have DVI format and human-friendly text format, as you see. And the interesting one is you do not need in this text format, you do not give all information, just small information right there. In text format, drop every information that can be calculated automatically. You do not give default values and everything. You do not give. Then
it makes ASM makes everything automatically. So I want to make some kind of internal format here, internal representation. Because DeepAI format, we have set 4 or 5 the same comments, right? The set 1, set 2, set 3, set 4. I want to have just one. For internal format, we drop all size variations down 1, 2, 3, 4. We have just one down. Then it's simple, right? I do not think about the registers, just down and right. Then I can do everything.
This is DBIS, the structure of DBIS.
Then what is annoying? The first one is Kernian ligature. So like the example of hello world, W, O, R, L, inside, between W and O, there is Kernian. So it is, there is a kind of Kernian information here. So without giving this Kernian information, we do not get a good quality. So how do we give Kernian information and ligature information in DBIS? Or when I read this one, it makes hard to read too, because it breaks our reading. So this one makes me annoying, the first one. The second one is GTEC and XDBI format. Because GTEC uses GID instead of US2 Unicode. GID means a kind of character, not character code, glyph code. So it is not, if it is the same as character code, I'll be happy, but many times it is not, it is different. So I cannot see what the character is, really. And another one is GTEC give X location, Y location. I know why Jonathan gives this one, yeah. But I want to make this one automatically. Anyway, this is my goal. And for Lua Tech gives in default UCS to Unicode. If I do nothing, it gives the Unicode. So, okay. But I said that is a font name convention. I'll show you.
Here is Lua Tech dump file. Because Korean Tech Core Tech is supports Lua Tech too. We do supports two type and everything. So there were some problem of developers how to give font name on Lua Tech. So they choose this kind of font name. This kind of font name. File LM Roman 10 regular, okay. Mode is node plus con plus liga. In this time, they use semicolon and write this micro type. All options were given by here because he wrote the Lua code to speak this one in Kotlin. No problem, but in DBI mode, I should interpret this information to change this DBI format to PDF. So I want to have some common convention of font name. This is the one. But the characters we can read. Oh, you do not read Korean characters. But it's the correct one. Correct one. And how about the GTEC? GTEC's dump file is this one.
Here. Font omega regular. Okay, no problem. But here, I cannot understand this one because it is glyphed. And X location and Y location, I cannot give this one. So it is a 1A.
it gives just one way. So I wanted to have some common fountain convention. Anyway, this one is. So in the final step, I tried to, in these days, in Korea, when we are developing Kotec, we have two choices, JTEC and LUATEC. So for LUATEC, we have many progress, and Lua has many modules embedded in LUATEC, like these kinds of modules. And for example, for using Lua socket library, we can fetch and typeset some internet information in real time by learning like this one. This one is the data in internet, and it is if I learn LUATEC, generate this one to this format, like this one. It is possible in LUATEC, because LUATEC has some kind of internet connection library in it. I do not give this one, just to see this one. And another one, Lua can use many shared libraries. It's easy. And Lua, I think the powerful aspect of Lua is this one. It is easy. So I discussed with Taco, and he said it's simple to make just this one. And just I gave this definition and they compile and get LUATEC. And then I can use all shared objects, shared libraries, like this one. So I'll give you a sample, like this one. I have SQLite, I use SQLite 3 database. There are this kind of information. And I want to fetch the data and make a table directly in real time. Here is a tech file, just a tech file. Then I learn divide Lua or Lua LaTeX, like this one. Then it runs and fetching data from DB directly and make a PDF file. And we can open dbtest.pdf like this.
I get
it. It is possible. So I thought that
LUATEC with a shared library is very, very powerful, really powerful. We can do everything, everything, but danger. I think Carl Berry says. Ten times danger.
It's really danger.
No, it's a multiple of three. It can't be.
So I asked Hans, because of security problem, we cannot give this property on LuaTeX. How about TechLua? Because TechLua is a kind of a script program. So. Oh, okay. This is. So I tried to make to convert the DYAS and the PY. It was already written in Python. In this time, I changed this one to DYAS and dot Lua file. But some program or some functions borrowed from shared library. I use this one, and I get the same result. So it was possible. If now DYAS can fetch font information directly because font forge library is included in LUATEC. I can use this one simply. So I thought that future of DY well. Here we have DYAS, text format, internet format, and DY. We can go anywhere here. not bi-directional, but one A is always possible. In simple way, because tech Lua or Lua tech gives many libraries, and if there is no library, we can make a shared library. So I'd like this kind of big picture I want to have. And this is my next project or dream in some sense. One program controlling everything in DeFi format. So this is reference of my talk. Any questions?